This video features 10 questions from our exam preparation materials for the 14th edition of BICSI's Telecommunications Distribution Methods Manual, or TDMM. Chapter 20. Residential Cabling. You will have 10 seconds to answer the question before the correct answer is revealed. There are two grades of residential telecommunications cabling. Grade 1, residential cabling, meets the minimum requirements for telecommunications services. Residential telecommunications cabling provides an allowance of 10 meters, or 33 feet, for patch cords or jumper wire, and equipment cords. With residential cabling, coaxial backbone cabling may be implemented in a bus or star topology. In residential cabling, the ADO provides the means for the tenant to disconnect from an access provider, or AP. When designing a residential cabling system, equip the distribution device, or DD, to add 20-50% more cable runs than the original installed number of runs to provide for future growth. For residential telecommunications cabling, the length of each individual telecommunications outlet cable shall not exceed 90 meters, or 295 feet. When designing a residential telecommunications cabling system for a multi-dwelling unit, the space where the backbone and ADO cables terminate is the common telecommunications room. True or false? When installing a residential telecommunications cabling system, the entrance bridge in an NID may be used as ADD. The correct answer is false. True or false? Coaxial residential telecommunications cabling shall be verified to ensure continuity. The correct answer is true. Questions in this video have been taken from the BICSI TDMM 14th edition manual and not from an actual exam. This material is meant to be used as a study aid and not to replace the actual TDMM manual. Thanks for watching.